you want to not only just a simple service, but any other service also, we can help you with that in next few weeks. Okay? Now we have our email, you have your emails and all, we will support you. Okay? So with that, as I said, since you guys, you know, learned all these things, how to do this, definitely don't forget to get your certificate. Who has good handwriting? Again, if you can raise your hand.
There is a trial link that you can go back and request for a trial. It's only a 30-day request period, but you can extend it to another 30 days, so that will give you 60 days. I know that's not enough. So to be realistic, you would probably want to buy your own compute environment. And I just checked online, and this is list price, right? Nobody pays list price at Oracle, so hint, hint.
We are not able to decide.
Didn't we promise Larry and some yacht?
I think if the yacht won't fit out.
33.
33.
So is that?
33, let me check. Kirti Nandan. Kirti Nandan.
Kirti Nandan.
Okay. Next number.
He has to be present here.
Not here.
Not here. Once. Arun Kasireddy.
Just show you. I'll list it. Yeah.
Arif Maru.
I'll also have
Naga Satya Rama Sandeep Kota. One name or? Srinivas Ratila. Vaibhav Rupapara. Vaibhav. From Hyderabad hackathon events, many built afterwards and pushed it to GitHub. You know, this is one, I know there are a lot of end developers here. This is one of the things you can really put it on your resume and make it count, right? So typical agenda, we'll start with overview. Rajat Datla will give an overview, and then Ravikant will walk through the technical steps of what you need to do step by step, right?
important to know. You know, it's still an early in the cycle, so if you are learning microservices hands-on, still, you know, not a, not too late. Still early in the cycle. Okay, so software architectures. If you look at the software architectures, you know, I mean, if somebody could write a program in 30 years ago, that was a big deal. People used to write in assembly language. Take your monolithic application, you divide that logically based on the functionality into different microservices, right? Not every microservice is of the same size. You know, this its purpose is to do one autonomous function. Not necessarily to say, this is 1 MB, that has to be 1 MB. No, it can be 100 MB, but as long as it's autonomous.
When it's monolithic, you have a clear orchestration of the services.
Correct.
When you split it into microservices.
Your service will do is you just write three methods in random. If you know how to do the Java thing random, right? You just use a math library random and generate between 1 to 77.
Who wants to volunteer? Maybe a couple of groups.
Yeah.
Can do that.
That'll be a fun service. Right? Hopefully you get picked. But if you want to do that, it's a very, very simple service. So I can help you with implementation.
Again, the game for the data, but it's not efficient. So we have to solve that problem realistically. We're redesigning the application. So that if one guy violates that one, you're still causing issues for everybody else if they don't follow the application. So that's why we believe in what we call it is a prescriptive microservices approach. Means somebody decides these rules and enforces these rules. Our platform will design with that in mind.